Testing.
All right, guys, we are back and we're going to do a quick test here. And yeah, my iPhone 11 is not working for us today. This one is working just fine. So I'm going to go ahead and pin the comment. We're doing Bolo Saturday today. Happy Saturday. In the comment, I'm going to put the topic. So
awesome. So last week we talked about pots and pans, and after that we scored a set of copper bottom pots and Revere pans and pots, and we're going to list them today. Hopefully we'll keep you guys updated and see what happens. So today we are talking about cameras. When was the first camera that we sold? Do you remember anything about it?
The first camera that we sold, I don't remember anything about, but I think you're the one that started. I think it was the AE-1 Canon.
Yeah, I think we were going to a lot of estate sales, and a lot of people collect cameras. So I don't know. I like anything vintage, so I just picked up anything that looks cool. So we picked up a Canon AE-1. And we had no clue how much it was worth, and we sold it for over $100.
Yeah, and we were like, oh wow, that's really awesome. Well, you're gonna find out today that that camera goes for over $400 easy. So we kind of, we were giving it away.
Yeah.
Honestly. But okay, don't make the same mistake as us. And we're gonna show you, you know, what to get and what to look for, and let's go ahead and do that so that you guys don't make the same mistake as we did and don't give away your profits.
So in terms of cameras, you can find them everywhere, not just at estate sales. You can find them in garage sales. We've gotten some at thrift stores. So these are definitely items that you need to be on the lookout. Some of the brands here are really, really rare. But you never know, right? Treasure hunting is always fun. So, without further ado...
Awesome, yeah, let's get started. Okay.
Get started.
So number one is the Leica Q. The Leica camera brand is a really fantastic brand. It really holds its value. So the picture that you see here is from 2015, and we found one that sold on eBay for $4,811. Good morning, Junctiva. Happy Saturday.
So Leica is a very, very famous brand. They're from Germany, and we were lucky. We've gotten one so far in our reselling history, and that was from an estate sale. However, keep in mind that these guys are not going to sell them for cheap. So you do have to make a little bit of investment. I think we bought that camera for $100. And you could easily, you know, make a lot more. So the investment is not cheap, but these are certainly like cameras that are really rare and valuable.
Happy Saturday, Tootsie Avila. How you doing? We are discussing cameras today. Some vintage, some not. So the second highest one is another Leica. They're really beautiful, the way that they're made. And this is a Leica M10P Ghost Edition for Hodinkee from 2017. No idea what Hodinkee is. Do you know what that is?
I don't know, but Leica is very famous for the texture of the unfocused regions in their pictures. So that's why they're so expensive, because the quality of it is amazing. High contrast, and if you Google Leica photos, you'll see the images from a Leica camera.
Tootsie Avila says it. I'm okay. I pulled a muscle in my back and can't source today. Boohoo. Oh my gosh. Please stretch every day. Please be careful. Muscle pain in the back is not fun. It is really, really, really,
not
really
fun.
Really, really not fun. So we are so sorry to hear that.
Stretching.
Please be careful and stretch every single day. It's very, very important. Especially doing the work we kind of do too, you know, where we're like lifting a lot of things.
Yeah.
Our movement is a lot of like bend down and stand up, down and stand up, lift heavy items. So again, Tootsie Avila, we wish you to feel better soon. All right, and let's go to the third one here. We have a Kershaw Peregrine 3 camera. This is from the United Kingdom. This one is vintage. It's from 1948, and we found on eBay, it sold for $5,532.
And this camera is quite rare because this brand only makes cameras in 2 years from 1948 and they stopped. So this is actually has the cover where you can kind of open up the lens and it pops up. So be on the lookout. I've never heard of this brand, but definitely I would actually forego this brand if I see it at a sale. So now I'll be on the lookout.
Exactly. Titsy Evelyn said being old doesn't help either. LOL. I know, right? Every as time passes, it's easier to have aches and pains and cricks and whatnot. Yes. All right. So the next one is another Leica camera. Leica MM Digital 24 megapixel digital camera. This is from 2012, but it still kept its value at $12,000. When you look at a Leica, it looks like a very simplistic camera, mm-hmm. but the price tag tells you otherwise.
Yeah, and when in my head, any cameras that are digital are not worth money. I don't know where this came from, but this was what I was thinking, so I actually forego all the digital cameras when I saw them at the sales. However, digital cameras are actually worth money, so focus on the brand. If you see anything like us, snatch it.
Yeah, Leica's good, vintage or new, no matter what. L-E-I-C-C-A, Leica. All right, here's the next one.
Here is the Rolleiflex 2.8 FX. This is another camera that is rare, but doesn't mean that you can't find it because they're quite popular. I've seen some in online estate sales, and
people. So is it rare or popular?
Well,
is it a unicorn or not?
It's not a unicorn.
There you go. So it's not a unicorn, but
not super common either. You
honestly,
know what I mean?
Yeah.
So this was made in 1952. And if you look at it, it has two lenses. That's what makes it really like different. So this is called TRL. TRL stands for twin lens reflex. Twin because there are two lenses. Reflex means that the photographer looks through the lens to view the reflected image of an object or scene on the focusing screen. Photographers also look through SLRs or single lens reflex. So now I know what SLR stands for and what TLR stands for. This was sold for $3,370.
Rolleiflex.
Correct.
Keep your eyes out for Rolleiflex.
And this is a brand from Sweden. Germany.
Germany. Awesome. All right, so here's one that we have sold. It's called the Kodak Metalist 3. If you are out and about, you know, looking at vintage items, estate sales and whatnot, this is where you could find them. And most Kodak cameras, even though they're vintage, are not really that valuable, even yeah. though they're one of the first, you know, companies out there. But this one is, the Kodak Metalist 3 sold for
$400. And we found one at an estate sale, but we sold it for less than $400.
Yeah, so that's not when we were on top of our game. We're on top of our game now, though. And so we know how to price things really well now. And anyway, 1953, it's a really cool looking camera. It'll sell quickly if you were to happen to find one.
Awesome. This is another great thing to look for. Hasselblad. And this is a Hasselblad 500 C. Carl Zeiss lens. Hasselblad is from Sweden. This was made in 1957, and this was sold for $735. I don't know if you guys are familiar with Hasselblad, but when they went to the man walking on the moon, they actually used the brand Hasselblad cameras to shoot. So this is why they're so famous, not only because of the quality, but because of that.
All right, well, I'm a big man on the moon nerd. And by the way, the anniversary is coming up. We should get all of our pictures listed.
Yeah,
we should do that.
Wait, July?
July. No, we're in July now.
Oh, July.
It's coming up. The anniversary, I believe, is July 21st. We should get all of our pictures back up for Man on the Moon. But I'm such a nerd that if I see this camera, I would want it just because they used it in you know, on the Man on the Moon walk. And Tootsie Avila said, I really appreciate these videos. I've learned so much because of you. You're so kind, Tootsie Avila. We really appreciate that feedback. Thank you so much for telling us that. And we do hope that we can help you guys, you know, grow your knowledge, but also make some money with the videos that we are making for all of you. So thank you again. Valet Cindy, happy Saturday to you. Have you guys ever sold any cameras? We've sold a few in our day, and they do really well on eBay. We've sold them on OfferUp, and
Etsy
is known for, you know, vintage cameras.
Yeah.
Good morning, Lauren DLI. Happy Saturday to you.
So this next one, this is, I would say, a knockoff of the Rolleiflex.
Yeah, it looks similar.
Because it looks exactly like the Rolleiflex, except this is a Minolta-branded camera. So this is called a Minolta AutoCord 3 TLR camera. Anything with TLR, anything with two lenses, definitely look for those. This was made in 1955, between 1955 and 1966.
Minoltas are pretty good too. They hold their value pretty well too. Not in, so much in the thousands that we've seen, but in the hundreds, which is still nice.
This was sold for $460.
Which is not bad.
All right.
Okay, so we have sold this camera before. This is a Nikon Chrome F2 camera from, it was made during the 1971 through 1980s. And this one sold for $355. It's just a good quality film camera that they don't make anymore. And film, if you know, you're not aware of, is extremely popular right now in photography. All the young people, Generation Y, X, and Z, are looking for these on Etsy. So these are really good Bolo finds if you are to run across them.
So I do have to give you guys some tips when you guys are sourcing for cameras. Don't react immediately once you see the cameras, because you gotta make sure they're clean. You gotta make sure they work. If you buy a camera that is not working, it's probably not gonna worth much money. So the first thing you do, look through the lens, see if there are any dots. Usually, like, if they're not clean, there you would see black dots inside the lens. And then the second thing is turn the little winder, making sure it's worked. You know, making sure as if you're taking a photo. If you hear the click, if it goes through, it means it's working. So look at the lens, open the cover, look inside to see if there's anything like growing, any mold on it. So that's a really important thing.
Now, do these cameras use batteries?
No.
So how do they work then?
It's all mechanical.
It's all mechanical.
That's why they're expensive.
So I feel like that's why they are worth money.
Exactly.
All right, let's get to our last one.
Yes, our last one. This is the Canon AE-1 35mm SLR camera. This was made in 1976. This was our first camera sold when we started reselling. And this was sold for $491.
Yeah, we sold ours for very cheap. We didn't know better. We sold it for a little over $100. They went like hotcakes, of course.
Yeah.
People probably bought them to resell them from us. But we sold like three of these ones. So they are out there.
But
be careful, make sure it's AE-1, because there's a lot of similar ones that look the same, but they're not worth as much.
Exactly.
Good morning, Nakia Ray, happy Saturday to you.
Again, we found one of these in estate sale, we found one of these
garage sale,
so yep. You never know.
Mm-hmm. Yep. All right, and last but not least is our meme of the day. I don't know if you guys remember these disposable cameras from back in the day in the 90s. We used to use them all the time, like when we'd go to Disneyland or something. But, you know, kids will never know what it was like to take a ton of pictures and have to wait a week to find out that the pictures were useless.
I remember that.
I mean, how disappointing when you would, like, wait for a week or more and your pictures were not even in focus. You know what I mean?
For those of you who didn't grow up in the 90s, basically you can't see the photo until you get the films developed. So this happened to me when I was younger. I kept clicking and clicking, and you know, yeah, this is funny.
So Tootsie Evelyn is asking a question. She said, do they have the model name on it? Yes. Canon
on the left side.
Canon one does have the model name on it, AE-1. Some of them don't, I don't think, but they have the name of the camera and you just have to know what it looks like.
Yeah, and Tootsie Evelyn, usually they're engraved. Usually they're engraved on the metal part of the camera. This one, you can see AE-1. For Nikon, you can see F2. In most cases, you could see it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But again, also try to memorize what the camera looks like, because they're very unique in the way they look. So that's our suggestion. So again, thank you so much for joining us today. See what you could do. It's a little bit difficult to find these online because I feel like a lot of people know that they're valuable. But if you're willing to put down some money and flip it and know, you know, that you can get money, go for it. The best place, as Michelle and I mentioned, that you could find these are estate sales from a camera collector or something like that. And if you get lucky, you may run into them across a couple of garage sales. So
And thrift stores.
Yeah, thrift stores would have them. Good point. So so that's it for today. You know, put this in your repertoire. We're building slowly. We have Bolo Saturday last week was pots and pans.
Board games.
And then we've done board games. And then we've done vacuum cleaners. Put those in your repertoire. Put those on your search lists. We're doing things for you that will give you some nice profits. If you do happen to find or run across any of these, please tag us and let us know so we can help celebrate with you. You can tag tag Flipping Gals Bolo so we know that you got them and that we're able to help you out. So best of luck on your journeys and reselling. You know, COVID is rampant in California and the U.S. now, so you can source online. They have estate sales online. You can source, safely on marketplaces like the neighborhood apps, Facebook, OfferUp. And what we've been doing is when we are sourcing in our neighborhoods, we wear a mask and we ask that the person who is selling their item to us also wear a mask or better, leave the item outside. We will Venmo you, send you a digital payment, or we'll leave the money tucked in underneath your mat. So far, no one has had a problem with that. If someone does have a problem with that, then it's very simple. We just won't pick up the item. It is not worth our health or anyone, you know, exposing our health to make a couple bucks. So Anyway, hope you enjoyed this, guys. If you're listening to us on the podcast, please, submit a review. If there's any feedback you want to give us, please send us a DM on Instagram. And have a beautiful day. We will see you on Monday. We're going to take Sundays off now and give a free day to us. We need the rest. But we will see you Monday with another live.
Have a great weekend.
Have a wonderful weekend.